with the extensions on. Make sure nothing is poking. Hey everyone. Today I'm gonna show you how I blow out my hair. Well, the fake way to blow out my hair, the easy, lazy way to blow out my hair, plus some extensions from Unice. I got sent these extensions. I got two bundles and they come packaged like this. And they're premium quality Malaysian 24-inch extensions. So they are completely real human hair, super long. So I can't wait to style these. They match my hair color right now. And yeah, I've got a photo shoot to go to. So this is gonna be important as part of my little routine of get ready. So I already got one bundle opened up. And so basically it comes like this. It's a little bit lighter than my real hair, but right now in the lighting, when it blends, it really brings out the gold tone. So this is what it comes in. It comes with two clips. So these are clip-in extensions. I've got another two clip ones. So there's two of those. I've also got a wider three clip one. I got some little short ones, but they're two clips, but they're like about 3 inches wide. I've got another long wide three clip one, and then little one pieces here and there for any like spots that you might need to conceal, and then another two pieces. So all in all, there is 6 pieces, 2 of each. This is like my hair brushed out, completely natural, super dull and lifeless. But this is what my real hair looks like. I know I have like a whole bunch of videos basically featuring all the different styles and like wigs that I wear, but I wear them because I like to be lazy and not do this. So today you're gonna see me not be lazy. I've got a photo shoot to go to at 2 o'clock. It's like about 1:30 right now. Let's see how fast I get through it. This is my hair and we're gonna add some more length. I've got Hot Tools. This is like a 2-inch barrel. This is what I use to replicate like a salon blowout. So I don't have my hair wet. I don't have time, nor did I ever learn how to really blow out my hair. So starting off, I'm gonna go ahead and get your clip ready. I just grab my fingernails and go right above my ears. And then I'm just gonna clip this up, unclip them, and then I'm gonna go ahead and just kinda like feel where the part is, and I'm just gonna kinda like twirl it around in here, really make sure it grabs, and then clip it down. Grab another part, make sure it's all in there tight, clip it down, and then the left side. Since I'm just going to do a photo shoot and I'm not going to be like all dancing around and prancing around, I'm not really too worried about it coming off, but there is a more like way more effective way of using this if you're going to be moving around and you're afraid of it sliding off. But basically it's the method where you kind of tease the hair and then you clip it into those knots and tangles. I'm not doing that. I just kind of like fidget it around and then clip it down once it grabs on. So that's what I'm doing. So this is the first one. Like I said, it does match the existing highlights I already have in my hair, which I want to bring out. And then we're going to go on to the next layer. So I'm going to go about half an inch above that one. About half an inch over that one will be the last one I will put on the top. And I'm going to go to the next widest set, which is this wide two-clip one. And I'm just going to put that up here. I don't want it to go too high because then you'll see like all the bumps. And sometimes the clip sticks out. And that's like the flattest part and volumeless part of my hair. It'll be very, very noticeable. So I make sure this area is not too crazy. So I have about 3 clips in right now. I always add a couple on the side. So I'm going like maybe 2 inches over my left ear. I'm clipping that. And then I'm getting one of the short 2 pieces, 2 clip ones on each side. So that's how it looks. And this is just gonna bring out the subtle baby highlights in my hair that I already have. And then you can go along, like if you see any pieces that might need some more, you've got these 2. And if you have a larger head and if you wanna like put in like a more longer effect, then instead, you know how I went over my ear on the very first clip that I put in, you can go even below your ear and that'll give you longer hair, because the lower you put it on your head, the longer it'll hang, of course. So I'm good on length right now, so I'm not gonna use this one as I don't need it. But when I had shorter hair, I definitely started the first weft here, the next one, and the next one. And I'm pretty good as far as volume, so I'm not gonna add these little fillers. I'm gonna brush all of this out and blend it and get it ready for the hot tool. I always start on one side, so I just parted it in the middle. And I'm gonna start on the right side. I'm gonna clip this up, get it out of the way, and I'm gonna show you how I do this little fake bootleg ass blowout. Sometimes you gotta go through these and make sure like they're not, the corners of these are not sticking out, because it will snag hair, which that will stick out. So about the corners, because it'll make your hair fold or stick out. It's not really so much the actual clip. So I did do a double take. Everything's all secure, so we're gonna go ahead and start. First thing I do is take little rectangle parts of my hair that are thick enough, and I blow it up and out when it's around my face. So I'll go like this. I always start in the middle and just pull up this. And I wait like about 15 to 20 seconds. And then let it fall. You want to let it cool like in your hand before you drop it, Or you can be like me if you don't have time. Alright, you just get like one of these little salon clips and you just kind of like let it hold the form. And when this cools, it's gonna leave the volume, it's gonna stay in that shape. See, if you have like really unstylable thick hair, it means it's healthy, it means it's actually a good thing. If it doesn't hold a curl, like the more it holds a curl, if it's greasy, if it's been super processed and unhealthy, then it'll hold the curl. But the top of my head, usually around this area, it's very thick, very healthy, and it won't hold my curls. So I gotta do this method. Plus, I like to do it because like I like the top to be volumized and then be a little bit more loose ended on the bottom. So this is basically like the little curvature it does. It's very subtle, very, it just looks like it's like a little blowout. You know, it's not like a tight curl. It just leaves it very natural-esque, which I really like the look. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that throughout all my hair. And then we'll do the left side. And make sure you just treat the extensions like they were your real hair. So the way you're gonna blend it all together with your real hair is by curling it and styling it together. So definitely do not style it on its own and then put it in, or style your real hair on its own and then put it in. Like, style your real hair and the extension together, and then it'll blend and just look super natural. No one would even know. Alright, this is the first half. It's just blended and it looks like a blowout. Alright, so I took down the little bangs part and I basically am done with the whole right side of my hair. And as you can tell, this is the before. This is the after. I think it took less than 10 little curling sessions for it. And it just gives me this look. Like, it looks like I just got out of the salon. So this is my favorite look. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish this one. I'm gonna start with my bangs first, so that way when I'm all done with everything else, this would have cooled by then. Alright, so this is the last piece. And I'm just gonna let my bangs out. They should be cooled by now. And just run my fingers through my hair. If there's any like straight ends, I'm just gonna curl them. Don't do the 15-second rule on your ends because you'll fry them. Plus, they don't need to be that long. They like pretty much go anywhere you tell them. And there you have it. This is what it looks like with the extensions on. Make sure nothing is poking. And this is what it looks like to have real pretty hair, kind of. And let's see the back. I'm scared of the back, actually. This is my first set of Malaysian real hair extensions. They are so cute. Like, it blends out so pretty because I just recently had like my hair dyed darker to kind of to kind of like not be so light before, but I could always bring out the highlights, the subtle highlights that I have in my hair with these extensions. So I have dark hair and these extensions are giving me life right now. They're making me glow and they look super summer ready and super pretty, and very, very caramel, like J-Lo-ish, Jessica Berciaga vibes right now. So yeah, let me know what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to rate. If you'd like to see more beauty videos, or let me know in the comments below what you'd like to see next. I'm definitely always look forward to your requests and read every single comment. So feel free to leave any below. And yeah, hope y'all have a good day. Stay tuned for the next video and see you then.